Despite severe interventions such as universal distribution of mosquito-treated nets to fight malaria prevalence, Ministry of Health figures show that about 140 lives are lost every day due to malaria. A new research now shows that a part of the problem is misconceptions about the disease.
If you eat a lot of mangoes, you'll get malaria. If you walk under the rain, you'll get malaria. Witchcraft can cause malaria. So because of all these funny myths and misconceptions, we as a project have gone out with education materials, with researched information, with facts about malaria.
The most vulnerable group of people that suffer and die of malaria are the children below the age of 5, expectant mothers, and those suffering from HIV/AIDS whose immunity are low. Working for 5 years to stop malaria within central, midwestern, and eastern regions, the implementing organizations have been able to discover that people's incomes and education have not flourished due to malaria, despite several interventions such as distribution of treated mosquito nets among the masses.
Children even miss days and weeks from school and their home until their teachers take the initiative to go and find out why they aren't in school. And the main reason the parents give the teachers is our child has malaria, and therefore we all know the symptoms of malaria.
A case in point is Bulisa District, which is among the 34 districts where stop malaria campaigns, such as clearing bushes and avoiding stagnant water around homes, plus distribution of nets, has had no impact. According to one of the community leaders from the Albertine Rift Valley region, Joseph Mwereza, communities instead use the nets to fish.
So they can use those to catch the what, the nkeji. So instead of sleeping in the net, which does not give you an income, when he uses it to, you know, to get some money.
With such frustrations to the efforts to fight malaria, it might be difficult to win the fight against malaria, which calls for a joint responsibility.